because the acceptance of our act of ibadah, or worship to Allah, is based on two points. First, whatever we are doing in this religion, Islam, must be in accordance with the teachings of our noble prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Meaning, because he was the one that was sent in order to teach us this religion. So we cannot go beyond his knowledge, or beyond the boundary of what Allah taught him. Whatever you bring into this religion that is not, or that was not taught by the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you consider it meritorious to practice it, that is what is called what? An innovation in Islam. So whatever things we are doing, we should make sure that it is in accordance to the teachings of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And secondly, the second condition of accepting our work or ibadah, it must be sincerely devoted to the Almighty Allah, only for the sake of Allah, only to earn the pleasure of the Almighty Allah, not for any material consideration or our personal gratification, but we should do it with a view to pleasing the Almighty Allah. These are the two conditions of accepting our ibadah or our charity or our, you know, jihad or whatever we are doing, you know, in the promotion of the religion of Islam. So may Allah help us. May Allah forgive us. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم ربنا أنزل علينا مائدة من السماء تكون لنا إذا لأولنا وآخرنا وآية منك وارزقنا وأنت خير الرازقين. اللهم ربنا أنزل علينا مائدة من السماء تكون لنا إذا لأولنا وآخرنا وآية منك وارزقنا وأنت خير الرازقين. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.